still your host, Steve Gate Realty. So I was doing a grind before, and I had something come up, so I had to stop, and that's okay. And I can keep going. Hopefully, I can get out all level goals tonight. If not, well, I can still make progress now, because I've got more health. Yay, health. Health is wealth. I've also got a little bit more strength, which means that I can deal more damage. And that's good. If more strength and damage and stuff makes the grind quicker. Which in turn reduces the amount of time I need to grind. That's why I'm doing my damaging stats first, and then moving on to the other ones. Also, whenever I kill something, I heal. So I haven't had to, like, what's it called? Heal the whole time. I actually wonder how this works, so we'll switch it on while we're doing this. Nah. It was very strength for Arthur and then agility. We're just going down the list, but I did help first, so that, like, wouldn't have to work on that as much. I've got a sizable health bar in comparison to where it was before. Do I not get XP for that? Oh no, there it is. Sometimes it's cool to dodge, sometimes it's cool to end up in a place that you don't have to dodge. Oh, its head falls off when I hit it like that, but that's okay. Copy that. I wonder why they can't go in there though. Those guys can, though. That's weird. First time I've had to heal in a while. spider kicking them off the edge is kind of cathartic. I want to lower my goals to make it mean. No. I know if I like shortcut it, I'll have trouble later, right? Pretty strength, 25 agility, 20 endurance. It was meant to be plus 10 on everything, but I feel like going for like small increments on the loss, it would be okay. Well, maybe round them all to 5. Nah, we'll stick to the original time, which was plus 10 on wherever they were. Everybody's gotta take too much time, but I got all the time in the world. No rush. It can make my life easier, and if I get clapped by another enemy, I know this was not the way. Check. easy, easy. Good. It's kind of good to be able to get hit a few times and not die. Got to admit. We're coming back with more XP each time. Makes him fall off, right? It's actually really funny. Oh no, just kills him. Three items are good. There's not really much to talk about while I'm doing these sections. It's kind of like I'm just killing enemies. That's okay. Sorry Zen about it, you know, just starting to think too much, pressing the buttons to attack. Could have done it in my off time, I don't really get that, but... Does it even count as an enemy? I don't know. Before it was like 3 hits to kill him, now it's 2, so this is worth it.
Yeah.
It's similar to Nioh for some reason, when you just like go around and summon dudes to fight. Kind of. The Nioh or Nioh? I always get confused. Gotcha. Oh, I'm poison. I didn't even notice I was poison. Oh, they keep killing dudes, so it's not a problem. I just heal for that. Slightly terrifying dude becomes, lets me know if I get enough XP to level up. It's kind of useful. Oh, nice. There's an achievement for that. I didn't get it the first time I did that, because I don't know. Just accepts his fate. I approve. I had to tell which of these enemies they're actually gonna spawn. Yeah. Oh, that's neat. You can combo. Spells with regular weapons. Okay. And even more of them spawn the longer you're in here. Also, very, very dangerous. Because, like, the starting area could just have the most dangerous monsters in the game, essentially. If you're there for too long, getting XP. Feels like a deterrent, and it's like, no, it's actually, like, the best thing ever. We're nearly there. I think it was the first 10 levels that were the hardest, just because I had less health. Now I'm just like, hey, that was nearly another 10 levels. Yeah, he's trying to increase my J's, yeah. How's it going? Welcome in. I wish I could be Batman. I would have no problem with, like, any of these things. He's got the best plot armor DC can write. I do not. And he got Fitzroy's up. Oh, I'm not early in the game. Don't be fooled. Don't be fooled. I figured out, I had a bit of trouble with one of the previous fights. So I was like, hey, because I started as a prisoner and my build's probably a few levels behind, I'm just gonna, like, do a little bit of, JRPG-style grinding. Which makes sense in the Umbra, because it spawns enemies that get stronger as you go along and you get an XP multiplier. So it's just, like, for me, free levels. If that makes any sense. Oh, really? Well, we can try to kill him, but I found that that was part of my problem. I don't have a high enough damage output, too. Unless, because I know I can lead him into this little room here, and nothing else follows me in, because there's nothing to, like, see out there. But he also turns off, like, my healing. He's also probably the most annoying mechanic I've had seen in this game, where he just like shows up and he's like, oh, by the way, remember how like we made a lot of bosses really hard to kill and stuff? We just added like a mob that spawns if you're doing well. Well, that's good, because this is a multi-class build anyway. So if I can get the self-heal, he's gonna have a tough time kicking my ass. At the moment, I've got a necklace that does the harmony and the radiant spells attached to it. Wait, what? Why? Oh, because he was easy to kill. So what you're saying is if, like, I got him on the patch 1, I could just be busted already? That is so, like, the people who developed this game, from what I understand. So I've been seeing so far, a lot of the fights feel like they were fair, and then someone went, hey, you know what? Nah. We need to make this harder. Why? I don't know. We just do. Like, some developer was sad the boss died too quickly. He's worth 25 per kill. Okay. Too bad he's got 20k hit points. Oh, fuck yeah. So he's just like... At first I thought it was just like a force to tell you, hey, stop farming on the Umbral. Now it's just like, oh, first he was designed to be like a mini-boss so you can farm off. Now they're like, nah, he's not. We don't want him dying a lot. Don't be silly. Enemies fearing you would be kind of helpful. At the moment, I've got, well, actually, yeah, enemies fearing you in the Umbral is great, because what happens in the Umbral normally is you have to transition through it sometimes. It's like, oh yeah, you know how you get 2 lives? No, you don't. You get 1, if you want to get anywhere. So what starting class did you pick? Because I picked the prisoner just because I like to go through and kind of like feel what the game's giving me. He can two tap me. How much do I have? I've got half of that. Love it when the enemies just straight up don't spawn. Oh, there we go. He spawned at the same time as another one, so I can't even do this fight. Yeah. I paid 80 bucks because I got it on Humble Bundle, so I got the discount, but I'm just like, I didn't want to be the knight, and like, they probably gave me that as like, I don't know, not even easy mode, just like, I'm gonna get a bad idea of what this game's difficulty is gonna be like if I'm not using buckets from the start or something, which I use the, you start as the prisoner with buckets. It's actually kind of neat, but yeah, that's how I ended up with this build. So, because when you're like free to level up stuff early on, you get all the benefits of. Oh, it's clearing? Oh, right, because everything's weak to radiance, right? I was a bit nervous about that, because Elden Ring, when I played it, did the exact fucking opposite, where it's like, oh yeah, no, Fate's cool, because you get some really neat spells, but it's also the worst build because you lose half your damage on everything that exists in that universe. Reaper? Is he the dude on the dragon? Yeah, it's the dude on the dragon. I thought the second fight I had with him was the actual fight, because he showed up out of nowhere, and I'm like, oh wait, no, that's just a scripted encounter that I get to lose, so that the game can remind me that I have made no progress in terms of being able to defeat him. That's cool. I did like that as a mechanic though, you get your achievement for dying in this game, because they decided to put two boss fights in a row. It's a weird introduction, really. Oh, that's good. Oh wait, is that good or bad? So wait, your foot was up his ass, but you're down a foot? Is that what you're telling me? it's because I wasn't expecting another fight on my way, so it's just like, okay, cool. Yeah, unfortunately, because I tend to multi-class in games, my strategies never really work until late game. So sometimes I'll be like, hey, this is cool, I can take out all the mobs, or the other way around, I can take out all the bosses but not the mobs. So my current Dark Souls 3 build, I basically got Dante from Devil May Cry, with none of the benefits of being able to hurt anything. Yeah, I'm a spell sword, so we got strength, vitality, and the idea being that because I can use Radiance and Inferno spells, and some of the weapons scale with that, I get the benefits of scaling weapons later on, hopefully. But all the drawbacks of being slightly weaker than anyone that did any single class, or two stats. But I'm liking the Radiant spelling if you play the starting one, where it's just straight up stronger than a sword. I thought that might be the case. Developers really have a hard on for that piety stuff. Like, you're strong and you're brave and it's justice. I'm like, I wanna be cool though. Which, there's something cool about justice. Well, that's a really good question. Okay, to put it into perspective, if you had an electrical hole put through you first, the sword would hurt a lot less because you'd be numb in that area. But if it was... Actually, yeah, because you'd go into shock, right? Which one would hurt? Okay, I've got the Mythbusters this on my YouTube channel. I guess we'll just, like, do a video of me getting stabbed and tasered and see which one I felt more. Wait, what? You probably stabbed again? Okay. What's the Crimson Ritual, by the way? To fight a person now, okay. What if that dude realized he was losing that fight if I wasn't surrounded? He looked like he was lower level, but I had no chance just because of the extra dudes I had to fight. I'm glad they, you know, didn't balance the PvP though. If I'm stronger than my opponent, I should be stronger than my opponent. That's great. And I'm actually, it's the first multiplayer combat content I've seen. Someone just like, not able to kill me, lagging their way through my chest. That means I can kill someone too. Should we try killing people? I need one more strength level till I've reached my strength goals. It'll probably take too long for me to do my other stats. I'm sure you're getting bored by me just like clearing this area. Do you want me to change? Is there another, like, location that's good for this? Okay. Thank you. I've only ever been kicked in the head. The weird feeling. I'll go to my latest vestige seed. That way it even helps you, because you need to be like, oh, he doesn't know what's after this. So I get my strength to where it needs to be, which is 30. So my plan was to get my stats up like 10 each. So yeah, the reason I'm grinding now was because I don't know if this was a hard boss or whether I was just like smooth brained the entire time, but I fought this guy for like 2 hours and decided I needed to be a little bit stronger. Okay, so it wasn't just me. Okay. So yeah, my vitality was 23, and my strength, like, I just went like, let's just do 10 on everything. Basically. Because my build needs all the stats, unfortunately. But for agility, it's more. Because it gives us access to, like, the great swords. His big orb explosion for me was instant death. I'm on PC with controller. But yeah, so is this area just up the stairs here maybe better for grinding, or is where I am pretty good? I'm not sure if the it's like area based for XP. Does that make sense? Okay, sweet. So what I'll do is I'll kill this lady here. Oh, that didn't nearly kill me this time. That's good. But yeah, I was struggling with this zone for a while yesterday, and I figured I might as well just get stronger, otherwise I'm gonna be struggling the whole game. Oh, you're level 120? I was level... whatever I am now, minus 20. How are you not dead yet? Oh. Yeah, so I was level 40. Is that too low? Am I in danger? Wow. I think that deals me a follow or something. Being like that under leveled for a like tough boss. I was wondering why everything was just like ruining my day by existing. Thank you for the follow. So what happened was, I beat the angel girl, I got up to the fan, and then I decided to take the game's advice and install it on an SSD, so I had to get all the way from the angel chick to the fan again in like a few hours. It was fun. Oh, that's the, that's the flying, that looked really cool. I do love that she uses that when you least expect it as well. Okay. So I kill her. And you're saying that these enemies yield me better... Oh shit. Okay, I can see it. Because there's stronger enemies here. $3,000 per blast. Those numbers I like. Yeah, so it sounds like I was right to figure that, like, to take the JRPG route with this. Because at first I'm like, Souls-like route is, I level up every now and again after a boss fight. This is, you need to grind, apparently. Cool. I wonder if they got a nerf it by the time I get to it, though. That'd be funny. $3,000 for... Oh, really? Good thing I'm not using that. I can't tell if I'm getting more XP or the same amount. I'm getting more, right? tasty. Am I supposed to just kill mobs and not grind the umbral here, or is the mob route the right one? Okay. So I'm better off just finding a spot too far in the mobs in general. Good to know. It's just because the umbrals and all, like, this is just right next to the, whatchamacallit. The vestige. So I figure I can just run back. So I need to find enemies that I'm able to kill quickly. Wait, what? They weren't spawning here before. I was just thinking quantity over quality kind of thing. If there's a lot of mobs. They must give you more XP. You kill like 4 or 5 of them. I wish that was the case. That's how I would have made it. Especially because they got a thing that spawns in there and tries to kill you. And nerfed it. And not nerfed it. Buffed it. Okay. So, I think the closest place I've got with top enemies then would be the hamlet. That was where I basically went off the rails and just kept pushing through on harder and harder mobs. Oh, that are the axe guys. Also, I'm not sure if you saw this on your way through, but my current build for like leveling up is I got the Ring of Nourishment and Bloodlust, so I kill people and they give me health. They're also spooky as fuck. This I'll go to the depot. The ale house. Because the problem is I can't move my vestige seat. Well, I could, it's just getting it back there is gonna be harder. Just because the run through was the pain enough to begin with. Nice. So you just like heal the whole time. Gotta wait. I totally forgot about that. Also gotta remember that I've been killing these dudes at like under level, so for me this was just the fight that I thought I had to go through to get through this game. I was like, yeah, that makes sense. The whole time. Yeah, my strength's not high enough for the ultra weapons. I look cool though. That's what's. Oh, really? There was another dude I saw on Twitch. He was doing the Souls-like playthroughs and he was using a hammer. So it must have made his life a lot easier too. Okay, these guys aren't giving me much XP either. It was like 300. Maybe I just move forward, but. Maybe. I see big weapon and go, maybe I can hit something. What's an item I missed? Sometimes I'll be like, I want Sword and Blur today, and when I build this character, I'm like, I want Battle Mage. Okay. Oh, I'm stuck here. Thank you. And my Dark Souls 2 playthrough was dual greatswords. I couldn't power stance him. I didn't even know what power stancing was till after. Oh no. I normally go the Berserker route. Not like Guts Berserker, but just whatever it feels like I'm hitting something the most build. He is. So I'm just like, you know what? Sometimes I'll just take a different route during a fight. Instead of carefully planning my moves, I go, what would Guts do? And Guts would just keep hitting. And not look at his health bar. And sometimes that's all you need.
Look out, baddies. Melchior.
Maybe Depo has more things to fight. 1800. I'm gonna have trouble. I deal 200. Also, I fought this mini boss here, and I didn't actually get to melee them. It was like my first fight where I had access to my spells, so I was like, okay, I just use like my spell cast on her, and it was really funny. She couldn't do anything. It's like stereotypical fighter with levels in Barbarian and one level in Rogue. Probably wondering where's the Rogue level coming from. Local man too angry to die. That's why I put points into it for Infernal currently, because I want to use the rage spell and just double my damage output. I know it's not double though, but I feel like it would be kind of cool. Be like, what do you do? I cast angry spell. Remember, sometimes not being seen is the best form of combat. Like, in Knights of the Old Republic, they point out, yeah, shields are cool, but not getting hit also saves you a lot of hassle. How fast are you in heavy armor? Well, I can run in it. Okay. How long? Yes. Yes, it's in a time. Yes. It's just crazy when you get into, like, because, there'll be people that are, like, fan over an anime, right? There'll be, like, things, Naruto versus Dragon Ball. And people are like, Naruto can just, like, copy himself and do a bunch of things, and it's like, okay, you need to remember. While Madara can summon a moon, Roshi destroyed a moon in season 1. Therefore, Master Roshi versus Madara isn't a fight. It's different universes, but the power scaling is insane. So, putting that into perspective, I think Guts could take out Madara, because Guts is maybe tank more damage than most of the Naruto ninjas? I don't know. Disgust. Also, the fact that these guys get hyper armor before they attack. That is also a combat option I've had the whole time. Yeah, exactly. Whereas, like, full power Naruto villains are like, they can summon a moon, but it doesn't actually do that much damage in comparison. I can't tell if this is being quicker or just more visually apparent than feeling too fighting. Yeah. I guess actually cutting something in half versus obliterating it takes more of a skill, but yeah, that's like weird power scaling, because essentially anyone should be able to do that at any point through training. Also, by proxy, since we're talking about power scaling, I think this character here from Lords of the Fallen, right, is maybe stronger than the Tarnished from Elden Ring. Now hear me out, it's because the second boss is Pieta, and Pieta is busted for his second boss. In comparison to Margit. Who is like a lot slower, doesn't summon angels, not quite as easily parryable, but still also quite deadly. Unless you haven't played Elden Ring, which case, I don't know. Well, the Jedi from Fallen Order? Some of the things I've done in this game don't feel like things I've done in the previous Soulsborne game. Also, I do have my damage nerfed a bit, but that's because these heal me as I fight. Yeah. So which one's your hardest by proxy in the... So, Superman can rotate the Earth backwards to change time. Superman stronger than Naruto? Okay. Yeah, no, actually, that makes sense. He's pretty tough. Yeah, Dark Souls 2, especially because. At some point you like rush through it, but it turns out there's a bunch of hidden like content around exploring and like backtracking and stuff with harder fights. It would. I didn't even rest. Okay, off the top of your head, where is a place I can go that has enemies next to a vestige that's not too far away that I can get back to fairly easily? Because this is too spread out. One punch launch. Yeah. Being all over would be painful. Bellroom vestige? Okay. Oh, right. Who's got the, whatchamacallit? These guys. I got an idea of fire damage because everything else was like not taking fire damage. Okay, I can see how this is quicker. Oh, there's a thing I haven't gotten yet. It's a Pilgrim's Birch key. So sad. Yeah, that's pretty rough. like crying someone out of existence above. I say to click the analog stick, but that's fine. It actually makes my life easier. I can just cross the bridge. I don't like fighting that dude. Like, there's no amount of transformations that, like, can help those guys survive in a lot of over enemies. I'm not even sure if Sakura would survive Lucky Star at this point. Okay, maybe that was a bit more than we could handle. It wasn't a lot of XP, but it did feel a lot quicker when I was in the other place. But I do like to change your scenery. Come on. Yeah. Oh, the attacks on the brain are always, like, interesting. That's why. When mages lose fights, it's only because, not because they got outsmarted, it's because they got, like, outgunned or something. Thank you. Oh, fuck. Okay. Yeah, I don't think I'm getting that bigger back. What do you think? Might be I get it back. Have it outsmart. Unfortunately, when I did that before, I aimed in the minorly wrong direction, and it wouldn't let me do that. I think I did that with the one on the way here. It's just when I did it, I just kind of like messed up the aim, like here. Don't get me wrong, the gameplay mechanics weren't lost on me. It's more like, as you saw, I'm under-leveled. So, because I assumed I was supposed to be pushing my way through this game, as I was. Don't ask me how I got to where I was. Either, I don't know. First time beating Pieta, because I had to do it again. I soul flayed her to the ground and did a visceral on her. I'm like, yay! And then I had to do it again. That was not yay. Yeah, probably. Someone in my chat the other week when I told them I had to do the start of the game again was like, I would have just given up. I'm like, yeah, but like, I paid for the game. I need to win the game. Whereas during this, I started Tales of Vesperia and then this came out. I'm like, you know what, I'll give this a go. And we're beating this game. Before I go back to my regularly scheduled streams. And the game knows. That's why it's like, look, you can fight the bosses, just don't kill them at a lower level than expected. No, they're dying. I can keep going right now. I'm just giving myself a better chance. Okay, there was like what, one level in 20 minutes? That's not bad. You didn't finish Monster Hunter World, I also stopped at the Guiding Lands. I beat the first base game, like, entirely, and then they brought out the expansion. I'm like, oh, okay. Cool. There was, like, every quest, every monster, static game. Y gear, which is the strongest type of gear you had, get a full set of that. Yeah. It can be either like grindy or just like weird sometimes as a game, so I can understand. I think I had to carry over people for that when I was playing. I like the constant battle. Oh yeah, that changes. Basically the way the cause I played 3 and 4 before I did World. Your level progression is done via the items. Do I even need agility? I think I do. Something will sail with agility. I'm not sure, but I forgot I can do that. It's like I just combo on something for long enough, it just burns to death. But yeah. Can be a bit of a long game sometimes too. I actually went through it a second time for like stream and I kept playing, not dying. What was happening with it? Oh! Yeah, I think someone like boosted me through it because they're being helpful and stuff for some of the fights. And like, you do realize that because we beat this game, I don't go back to it, right? They're like, what? So, someone helped me through the game, and suddenly they lost the content for it because it, like, it was over. I'm like, okay, cool, next game. Because I normally go for, like, a game once unless it's, like, really fun. But stream-wise, so I don't get stuck as being, like, hey, it's the Souls guy, or the Monster Hunter guy, or the Final Fantasy. Just... It's tough. Play JRPGs long enough, you get stuck being a Final Fantasy 9 speedrunner or some shit. I don't know. It's in the rules. Yeah, I remember finding this mid-floor here by accident, I was like, what? seems like this is definitely faster, because we got half a level just going through this section. Also, how do you feel about the wither mechanic here? Because I understand it's similar to Bloodborne, where like you get hit and you get your health back, but I don't like that it vanishes the moment you get hit. It's a little bit scummy on the health. Yeah. Don't know if I'm gonna get through this. I kinda wanna make more progress, but knowing that if I get into like another battle, I've got kind of like uphill moment of it. Knows. We got it that time. Bang. Yeah. That off the edge? No. Nearly. Okay, this is a level per lap almost. Doesn't feel like a lot. What time is it? 10 o'clock. I'd say... I know what my stats are supposed to be at later on, so maybe I'll just try to make some actual progress. Let's do that. See how this goes. After my next level. I'll do some math, but I think Sanctuary was technically faster just because I get to fight more enemies at once with the scaling XP. Or maybe it's because I'm fighting more enemies. It feels like I'm getting faster XP, but I'm just gonna get a level here. And then go to where we left Del Vestige. So at least I got some health. That was part of the problem before. That dude was invincible. Also, I wasn't one-shotting him before I started this, so that's good. What I might do is instead of running through zones, I'll just clear the enemies along the way, and then run back and heal, and that should at least work in place of grinding here. At least there's some progress being made, kind of. If I don't rush the area, as long as I can get back, it's not so bad. The run back I really don't like. Well, the run back for the souls, because when I die, I just forfeit them. Normally, I just go, I don't need these. I'll get more later. Works pretty well sometimes. Nearly got a level. I'm sure later on I'll find another spot that's better than this. For like, bow things. You see a spot with enemies nearby that is next to a vestige, and we're good. Let's get going. As soon as I figure out which way is forward. Oh, nice. There we go. There is a vestige there. Okay. That's neat. Oh, we got fire enemies again? Okay. Spill's not as good against things that are already on fire. But I do heal whenever I kill something. Easy. Okay. Oh, this is gonna hurt. Okay, that was one-shotting me before, which is good. We're not getting one-shot. But I'm getting set on fire. I have to swap my weapons and armor just to hurt this dude. But if he's resisting my attacks and still dying, it's his fault, right? So let's go there. So I'm gonna put my seed here. We got a few of those today. That's also why I was grinding in the Umbral to get the mana stones and other things. Oh, that's a way back. makes sense. Oh shit! That was lucky. Oh, nice. Okay. Why can't I roll out the fire? How'd that work? Easy. Easy done. Oh shit, okay, that was a mimic. I love their placement. Is there a way to know that they're mimics before you activate them though? I don't know. That's kind of funny.
Our holy work continues, Lamp-bearer.
Fellow sanctified vessel. May Aureus' divine radiance flow through me and into you.
It's the old Mondstadt sword? Let's get out of it. Oh, strength. Short sword. Long, no, it's long sword. Okay. That was another one. I thought that would be a mimic as well for some reason. That is not how that works. Oh fucking, you're joking. Please be a mimic. I don't fear dying as much as I think I should, so I just go for the items carelessly anyway. Like, okay, if it's a mimic, I die, it's fine. Not a mimic, I get loot. This is how I make my progress, by the way. Hence the grinding session. Go. Sorry, sir, I'm lost. Do you mind not attacking me for a moment? Thank you. Oh, there we go. I mean, that wasn't the right way. It was just a way to go. Okay. Ladders I haven't seen yet. Sir, I'm trying to find out where to go and you're not helping. Maybe he is helping. Maybe he's... So this doesn't seem like a good place to be now. Definitely feels like a place to be, but not the place to be. Oh, that's right. Okay, nice way in the opera now, so I can make my way around the place. Oh, never mind. Can't move. Oh, that makes sense now. I was like, why is that a good spot to be? That thing. You can reach from down there. I'm currently on PC. Why? So crossplay anyway. I have to get back over here. That makes sense. What do you mean there wasn't a way forward? Okay, we go somewhere, I think. Don't just feel like bored though, it seems sideways. Goal adjacent. Okay. Sure. So I got this person Osmox system my wand and immediately vanished. Why? What an interesting way to discuss things with people. Hi. Would actually be better. Oh, I see. Was that worth it? Absolutely fucking not. Will I do it again? Yes. Problem solved. We're back here. Maybe this is a good place to be? I don't know. Maybe I need to drop off the edge or something? That would make sense. Not there. Not there. It is just a place to get items. Okay. Well, we've done that. Or is that the end of the area? That felt like a dead end. Let's get 9,000 bigger and go get the key and see if that brings me to the right place. Because that could just be a dead end. Oh no, we found a place to go. I just don't recognize the direction. Okay. Go to Sanctuary, get enough for the key, buy the key, go somewhere else. See if there's a path for it. Just a reminder, that could be the last boss in the area anyway. I'm almost glad this was a grind episode, because I would have gone there and be like, where am I supposed to go? Panic. And I'm just like, wait. I don't need to worry about progress as much, because... we're just here. Nearly there. Unfortunately, this isn't for a level, this is for the key. I don't know how it chooses to spawn enemies. Oh shit, he's already dead. Okay, we'll go get the key. Skyrest, and then see if I can continue the game somewhere.
In Radiance, Judgment. Our Immaculate Lady will bring redemption.
Oh wait, there's another place I can go to, right? That I just unlocked by doing this. It is Sanctuary. Wait, this weapon bleed. It is bleeding fire. I just want to do anything. Oh, it scales off. Okay. Which makes the spear just better, right? Oh, the Saint's Halberd. It does poison damage. It just scales better. I'll upgrade this. Okay. Do I want to level up the weapon? Yes. Okay, we're gonna do another run of this. Level up the spear that does poison damage. Apparently that's good, maybe. Yeah. Deals bleed damage. That's why its actual damage output's low. We got poison, bleed, wither, radiance. I think it's like it deals fire damage, and that's what my right sword does. So when we hit something, we hit with all the elements at once. We'll never see what's coming. So no, actually, no, I don't understand why that would be a dead end. Because, like... doesn't make sense. It's the way it was going. Is it linear or not? Because there was a boss there too. Oh, deals 237 damage. Okay. the way forward. And enemies that don't die immediately. Okay. But these enemies hurt me. Oh, okay. But I've got enemies that hurt me. What damage is it? These enemies aren't resistant to fire. Okay. Okay, now we're getting enemies that I've beaten before. That's cool. Okay. We got a direction to go in. I'm gonna call it a night there. Kissing out hanging out everyone. It's so cool. I can't wait. Enemies nearly killed me one shot again. Which means it's the right way.